On one of the individual items?
On 6.20.
Very good.
They're ready for me, I think.
Well, let's start off, I'd like if the council doesn't have a question, I know the treasurer has given the council a rundown of what she's planning on doing, and needs a month.
Yes, I received a letter and notification from Wayne County of approximately 400 properties within the city of Taylor that are likely to foreclose. These properties are delinquent in taxes, real property taxes, from 2018 and 2019. The county did not move forward on any foreclosures during COVID, so this is the first year that it has been started up again. I do want to make it clear to the residents that it's not the city of Taylor that is foreclosing on these properties, it is Wayne County. And when I spoke to Councilman Geis, we said that we have to do something to notify the members of the community and the residents and give them all of the opportunities that they could possibly have to keep their properties. So we've decided to send out letters via snail mail, just to make sure that the residents get the information in their hands. The notification they're going to receive will have a letter from myself, it will have a description of the PAYS program that the city has opted into to assist with the foreclosures, as well as the poverty exemption application, which is the first step of the PAYS program in order to qualify for it. Not every resident will qualify for this program, but this is something that we are offering. We are also offering February 16th, is it, for the county, the 16th?
It is the 17th, and I was going to cover that, but February 17th from 4 until 6 p.m. or until the last taxpayer is serviced. So they will go beyond 6. If people have dialed in to the Zoom,
yes.
They will stay on the line until every taxpayer is serviced.
Yes, and it is a Zoom meeting only, so it's just virtual. And once again, this is another reason why I wanted to make sure that the residents had something in their hands. Not all residents have access to internet, not all of them are on our website or Facebook, or know and understand how to operate a Zoom call. Within the letter that I'm sending, I also have my direct line as well as my email. I will work with any resident to help them fill out forms, to assist them in any way. My office is attached to the assessing office, which is that's where they would go to turn in their applications and get the program started. So we are there to help them at any time. It's of timely importance because these poverty exemption applications have to be given to the March Board of Review, which takes place on March 17th. So it's going to be very important for any of the residents that receive these packets to take action immediately. And the county makes mistakes, just like we all do. So if the residents feel that they have received this in error, I have the phone number and email to contact Wayne County because they are ultimately the ones that created the list of these possible foreclosures where you can reach out to them as well and I can assist with that. I know that sometimes it's not easy to get through to the county. And these are going to go out. We're going to start working on them, well, depending on the weather, I guess, maybe Friday. Hopefully to get them out in the mail on Monday, to get in their hands just as soon as possible.
Councilman Johnson.
I would just like to say thank you for doing this. I think it's very important. But on this particular motion, I have to agree with Iris Slade on this. I don't think it needed to come to us. We can discuss anything here that we want to. And it could have been brought as soon as you knew it. We could have called, you could have called three of us, and we could have called a special meeting. I don't think it needs to be on here, especially at $2,001. So that's my opinion. Thank you.
When did you get the list, Councilman Treasurer? And what was your...
It was last Friday.
And when, how long have you been asking for that list?
At least a week and a half, at least from the county.
So, in talking with the... the contact at Wayne County, who approached me at the MLK March, not only did he send us Taylor's list, and the idea was to share the information with the council here. I appreciate working with Treasurer, and quite frankly, I think we're doing this as expeditiously as possible. This wasn't sat out for any length of time, but I will say that I don't quite understand the issue with this. I mean, you know, we can do a budget amendment that is tens of millions of dollars, and we're squabbling over $2,001.
Mr. Chair?
Yes?
Just to clarify, I'm not squabbling over $2,000. I'm squabbling over, it shouldn't even have been brought to us, because it could have been $1,099 and it didn't have to come to us. $2 is going to make a difference. You could have brought it up, the Treasurer could have brought it up any time, and it could have been in the mail already if she had the list of time. So I'm just talking about the procedure. So that's my opinion. I call for the vote, or you can call for the vote.
Actually, there is another person that has already requested to have a public comment. So I call the your motion for calling for the vote out of order. You can challenge that and take a vote on it. If not, please read the question from the citizen.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. The comment is from Dan Dobbins. We appreciate the council's action to help forestall property tax forfeitures. It would also help if the poverty guidelines were revised so more low-income homeowners qualify. It's just not reasonable to grant the exemption to only homeowners who make less than $13,000 a year. No one can even survive on that income. Council has discretion to increase poverty income guidelines, and we urge you to do so. Signed, Daniel Dobbins, Taxpayers Action Group.
Any further discussion from the audience? Hearing none, all those in favor say yes.
Yes.
All those opposed say no.
No.
Roll call, please.
Mr. Slavin?
No.
Ms. Brandana?
Yes.
Ms. Clinton?
Yes.
Mr. Johnson?
No.
Mr. Ramek?
Yes.
Mr. Grant?
Yes. Motion passes 4-2. Item 7. Is there any discussion?
Mr. Chairman.
Councilman Remick.
Just to clarify, in reference to your motion, the motion, will that include the decision whether to place it and leave it on the agenda as we've done tonight?
It's not. For me personally, I don't want to debate the issue anymore. I don't want to debate the issue anymore.
I'm just trying to figure if I, and I agree with you as far as that position goes. I think it should, but I also think that somewhere here, I thought we were going to finally make that decision and settle this factor of whether or not we were going to go through and complete the decision on whether or not it will stay as part of the agenda at this time.
I believe there's separate